what is privatization, then privatization in Brazil, electrical system, privatization, many parts. So, what is privatization? Well, in the short course, privatization is the transfer of abuses or property from the government to a private sector. And this happens when the government has a financial difficulties or is not generating the necessary profits to keep being the owner of the company, for example. So, privatization in Brazil was had a huge incentive in the year of 1999 when it happened the Washington Consensus. And in this process, so it was a lot of ideas that refers to a free market. And free market economic ideas, and it was supported by economists and international organizations such as IMF, the World Bank, and the US, for example. So, in Brazil, in the same period that happened in this consensus, it was a color government, and color adopted some of these ideas of free market and creates the national privatization program, which has like an objective to privatize 68 companies. Well, he couldn't do it, did not take a serious program, and only 8 companies was privatized in that period, like in his means, for example. And then, after Collor, Itamar Franco used it, Collor, and keep the national privatization program, where the most important company that was privatized was National Steel Company, or Companhia de Serviço Nacional. After that, as Fernando Ricardo assumes the Brazil government and continues this privatization problem, he creates a National Privatization Council that adopts some ideas of Washington consensus. And he could do more than the other governments. He privatized Vale do Ribeirão, Telebrás, and Embratel. After that, so we have the government of Lula, and he continues the plan of privatization, but he focuses on federal highways. And like we have here, maybe at least 2,600 jobs of federal highways pass into the hands of private enterprise. And here is some of the examples of the federal highways. So now we're going to talk about Petrobras history.
Okay. Now we're going to talk about Petrobras history. The Petrobras company was proposed by Getúlio Vargas in 1954 during his project of the development of the country. The project faced great opposition and was only approved after 7 years of proceeding in the National Congress. On 1961, President Quadros authorized the union to constitute Petrobras. Here we can see the first logo of Petrobras. Some duties that Petrobras received when was created. The Petrobras should do promotion studies, construction projects, operation of generation plants, and to promote the construction of transmission lines and substations assigned to the country's electricity supply. So nowadays, half of the total of the lines of transmission in the country was made by Petrobras during this process. Nowadays, institutional reforms and privatization in the 90s years led to the loss of the sum function that the state had changed in the More than 90% of the installed capacity comes from sources with greenhouse gas emissions, like hydroelectrics, like Itaipu, and wind energy. Here you can see some of the companies that are subsidiaries by Electrobras. The principal are the CHESS, Furnas, the Temerit.
Now I'm going to talk about Electrobras privatization and why it happens. Electrobras has 233 power generation plants that include Furnas and San Francisco Hydroelectric Company, as well as 6 distributions all in the north and northwest. Well, there is a total of 61,000 kilometers of transmission lines that was enough to give a turn and a half event. But besides that, Electrobras has an actual debt of 40 billion reais. So, like you said, Brazil is in crisis, and Electrobras has a huge debt to pay. And with privatization, it brings us a great efficiency, for example, and we stop something like Brazilian policies that minus and energy ministry parties from they nominate the top positions of the top companies. This is a good point of privatization, but the bad thing is that government and the principal motivation for the government privatization is that since privatization happens because the deficits of Brazil, the wrong media costs. So the impacts that we all can sense is that electric bill will increase about 70 or 10%, kind of 7 to 10%, and that's because of the change of the operation and the bill will be expensive because about 14 of the plants that Electrobras generates